It is time to think beyond cloud infrastructure. Especially, enterprises need a mindset change when it comes to thinking about application infrastructure. Are you ready to listen? Modern Enterprise Tech Show. This is a weekly show where we talk about various topics related to modern enterprise. Today, I'm going to go solo. I'm going to discuss about how enterprises should think beyond the traditional ideas of cloud infrastructure when it comes to thinking about their application infrastructure. I think all enterprises want to modernize. There is clearly a need among enterprise decision maker that they want to completely change the way they are doing IT today, but their modernization strategy still hasn't evolved. When they think about modernization and move to cloud, they think in terms of using cloud infrastructure for their application. Rather, they need to change the way they think about applications and the infrastructure that supports their applications. To help enterprise decision makers decide which is the right way to go, I have identified four pillars which I think is crucial for any modern enterprise to bring it as a part of their strategy. The first one is application centricity. It is time to think in terms of applications when they look at the infrastructure. They should move from their existing thinking where they think about infrastructure. They think, okay, I need to use AWS EC2. And then they decide how they can bring in their application and make it work on top of AWS EC2. Instead, they should be starting with their application. They should see, okay, these are the services my application needs. These are the dependency services. These are the infrastructure services my application needs to meet the SLA needs, meet the governance needs, meet the security needs, etc. So they need to start with the application and then map out the infrastructure that is going to power that application. But if you start with infrastructure, what you will be doing is you will be sort of like compromising what your application is doing. Like you will be compromising on feature set, you will be compromising on the performance, you will be compromising on high availability, things like that. You start with the application as the center of your strategy and then map out everything else that's needed to make that application run in the way your organization demands, whether it's SLA, security, governance, performance, whatever it is. Start with an application point of view and then build out the necessary infrastructure, necessary dependency services, etc. The next thing is to have a service-centric view. I think we are still talking about infrastructure. Hey, I need EC2. Hey, I need a Kubernetes cluster. Oh, I need to look into serverless platform. Forget about that. Stop thinking about infrastructure in the traditional way. Instead, think of everything is a cloud service. Whether it's your virtual machine, your application is consuming, whether it's the Kubernetes cluster you're using, whether you're going with serverless platform, it doesn't matter. What your application needs are some fundamental, foundational infrastructure services and then dependency services like database, etc. So it is time for your organizations to start thinking in terms of cloud services. The abstraction could be anything. It could be plain virtual machine or a Kubernetes cluster or a serverless abstraction. It could be anything. It doesn't matter. Like, don't start with that abstraction. Don't start with the infrastructure. Start from the application point of view and think in terms of services. Think, okay, this is what my application is. These are the features I'm going to implement. This is the architecture of my application. Then decide what cloud services are suitable for making your application meet your organizational needs. It's time to think differently about the underlying infrastructure. Think in terms of, have a service-centric view, think in terms of cloud services, and I think that will help you better architect your application and ensure that there is a continuous It meets the needs of your organization. If you are watching this video, and if your organization is on the path to modernization, put yes in the comment, and it will help us understand how many of you are on your path towards your organization's modernization journey. The other thing is to think beyond infrastructure as code. Infrastructure as code is a very important concept that completely changed the way we consume infrastructure. In fact, when cloud computing came about and gave programmatic access to infrastructure, slowly we started thinking about how we can write code that will ensure that the infrastructure deployment and maintenance is seamless. Infrastructure as a code doesn't have its root in cloud computing. It has been there even since the virtualization era. We were using shell scripts in the early days. So that is infrastructure as code for your sake. So infrastructure as code is nothing new, but the way it is being used in at scale, I think that is what has made infrastructure as code a very important component of any enterprise toolkit as they go about modernizing their infrastructure. So, but infrastructure as code is pretty limited in the sense that, no, I'm not saying that it's not capable of doing certain things. Yeah, it is pretty powerful that way. But it is pretty limited in the sense that there is a very steep learning curve. And the fact that most of the focus on infrastructure as code stops with provisioning the necessary services. They don't think beyond provisioning services. They don't take into account things like, hey, how do I manage my identity and access management? How do I handle my secrets? How do I ensure that security and governance are all taken care of? How do I ensure that when my services go down, when my application sort of like the underlying infrastructure is handled on its own, just like how it is done in the case of Kubernetes, but across all types of services. All those things should come into play when you think about infrastructure as code. So there are two things that are critical. One is to make the user experience seamless with the infrastructure as code. You need to make sure that developers don't need to have that steep learning curve. Look at Kubernetes. The YAML complexity is a big problem. Companies like Pulumi, they're trying to solve that YAML complexity issue. And the companies like Filament and a few others who are still in stealth mode, they're all trying to sort of like take away all the complexities associated with infrastructure as code by going one layer above, probably at the workflow level, and making it easy for developers to take care of infrastructure without worrying about all the complex nested loops inside the code that is needed to run and handle infrastructure. I think we need to go one level above plain code when it comes to handling the underlying infrastructure. That includes handling identity and access management, governance, security, etc. So have a holistic view of infrastructure and operations. And also like ensure that you have the necessary abstraction that removes any friction when it comes to handling infrastructure in a programmatic way. Then the final thing is autonomy. There is quite a bit of talk about AIOps today. Every company is talking about AIOps. They are saying, hey, we are using machine learning to sort of like make it seamless to gain insights about what is happening in your infrastructure, how your application is performing, etc., etc. But AIOps is handled in an ad hoc way compared to how it should be handled. In fact, you should have a holistic approach about infrastructure and operations when it comes to tapping into machine learning and making it not only give insights, but give actionable insights, which then can be handled by tapping into all the automation engine. So you need to think of in terms of autonomy rather than machine learning giving you insights and then humans trying to trigger the necessary automation to make it work. I think everything should happen in an autonomous fashion. I understand that due to IBM's marketing in the past, Autonomic computing has become a problem, but I think we now have the necessary components that can be used to sort of like ensure autonomy when it comes to day one as well as day two operations. Let's take the case of infrastructure as code. The programmatic access to infrastructure has given an easy way to ensure that automation can be done. Then with the declarative approach to operations, in the case of platforms like Kubernetes and Terraform, you could define the end state and seamlessly handle all the necessary operational intricacies that is needed to maintain SLAs and governance. Now, when you couple that with the advances in machine learning and how machine learning can be used to tap into the observability data to give insights, I think it's just a matter of making that connection between the actionable insights that is coming out of machine learning to the automation part. And I think you can move humans from handling the nitty-gritties of IT operation to a more supervisory level. Think of a pandemic like what we have right now. I think if we had that kind of a platform, we could have easily avoided shutting down some of these manufacturing units or retail units, etc. I think you need to think beyond simple things like infrastructure as code or using some automation to handle certain part of your IT infrastructure to more into how do we sort of connect the insights that's coming out of machine learning engine with the automation so that anything even in the case of grave failures, remediation can be done without humans coming into picture. So I'm not saying take humans out of the equation. Rather, I'm saying put humans at a supervisory level so that these things can function in a more or less autonomic way. Just like what we are doing with self-driving cars today. Even though Tesla has that autopilot, you need to have that humans sitting in the driver's seat and making sure that everything is going fine. And if there is an emergency, humans can take immediate action. I think that kind of thinking is needed when it comes to a modern enterprise IT infrastructure. So it is time we revisit some of our legacy concepts. And as you go about doing your modernization strategy, you should think beyond legacy ideas and think in a totally different way. To conclude, taking a piecemeal approach to IT infrastructure is not going to work. Yeah, you can move to cloud. Yes, you can take advantage of modern technologies like Kubernetes or serverless engine. But unless your thinking changes, unless you look at day one and day two operations in a holistic way, unless you take advantage of the insights you gain with machine learning, with the automation to sort of bring in some sort of autonomic execution inside your organization, you are not going to really maximize your ROI with your modernization strategy. I think I want to use today's live stream as a call to action to think out of the box, think beyond what you are used to in terms of cloud infrastructure as code, AIOps, etc. Don't look at them in a piecemeal fashion. Think about them in a holistic way, bring them all together and build those autonomic engines that will drive your enterprise in the next 10 years. If that happens, maybe a pandemic like this need not have impacted so dramatically on our economy. I think we need to think beyond our traditional approaches. Think beyond the social media talking points about, hey, you need to use all AWS or otherwise you are not modernizing yourself. All these things. Take an application-centric approach. Think what are the foundational services and dependency services your application needs. Then take a programmatic approach to not only deploying your infrastructure, but also day-to operations. And then connect your machine insights you get from your machine learning engine running on top of observability data and make it all connect with your automation engine and make it all work in a seamless way. When you do it, you will have an autonomic platform that can help you run even when if the world comes to a complete halt in a pandemic. Think different. Think in long term. Don't just think in terms of, hey, I'm going from my data centers to cloud when it comes to your modernization strategy. I think that is the point I want to make today. I hope I made that point effectively and you find this video valuable. If you think like this video, please hit this like hit the like button in YouTube or Facebook. And we are going live every Wednesday at 1 p.m. and on Modern Enterprise Tech Show. And if you want to get notified whenever we go live or whenever we post a video like this, please hit that subscribe button and then click the notification icon so that you get notified every time. And I hope you like this video and I'll see you next week.